Alright guys, KendoFox here, and today we will be playing Clock Tower 2 Struggle Within using still the PlayStation mouse, and this is actually the continuation of Clock Tower Scissorman that we finished yesterday. And for the record, I actually played Clock Tower 2 Struggle Within before Clock Tower Scissorman way back. Like, I played this around 2001 of summer at my cousin's house using his PlayStation, and I was really curious about the cover of Struggle Within. And well, as a kid way back, I just played Spyro, Gex, UTR, and games like that. And for me, Dino Crisis is really a survival horror scary game, but this game is on the next level. Like, this thing is really scary, and I believe that Clock Tower 2 Struggle Within was the first point and click game I played. Yes, it can be Dune 2000, but it can be Clock Tower 2 Struggle Within as well for point and click. So yeah, without further ado, let's play Clock Tower 2 Struggle Within.
Alyssa just called. She'll be arriving tonight.
Do you really think it's okay having her stay with us?
The children don't know anything about it. Everything will be okay. Anyway, Ashley will be home soon. Don't look so worried. That might be Ashley.
I'll go and see.
Alan Hale, that Maxwell curse is...
All right. So, yeah, we finished yesterday Clock Tower Scissorman, but to be honest, I don't know how to, like, stitch up the story from Clock Tower Scissorman to Struggle Within. So, let's play.
Hello, Uncle Philip, Aunt Catherine, it's Alyssa.
Scenario 1. Cursed doll.
What was that?
So I will be doing a voice acting here of Alyssa. Switch. Ooh. What's this?
What's that? A leg. Only a leg. Oh, I wonder what this yellow liquid is. this key goes to.
Oops. A washing machine. You have discovered hint number one. View hint now? Yes. Aliza and Bates encounter different events. If you find yourself unable to continue, first change personalities by putting down the amulet and then try again. Okay. I'll keep that in mind.
It's pretty full.
Yellow blood.
What happened here? A human torso!
Uncle Philip and Aunt Catherine. So, we need to meet up with those guys. Yes, dining table, a huge dining table.
Oh, the line's dead. This fireplace can still be used.
All right, we have a dining key. Everything is normal here. The door is locked. All right, let's use our dining key. Ooh, an arm.
What is that?
It's an arm. Yeah.
What? How? It's only an arm?
Crazy. Alright, so I guess we need to go upstairs to find more clues, because doors in here are still unavailable. There must be like dots, and see. Compared to this, not dots but triangle. So we have no option to open this yet. Same goes with this room. So let's go upstairs. Ooh, gross.
No! Oh no! Ashley! My amulet? No, stop!
Don't be afraid, Alyssa.
So based on our hint number one, I actually do have two personalities. And it was stated that I just need to put down the amulet if I want to return as Alyssa. But it seems that I don't have the amulet yet. Let's see, let's investigate further.
Yellow blood. Who bleeds yellow blood?
So like, whenever she's glowing, she's possessed with another personality, which is Bates. All right. So let's check other rooms. Here, let's check this. All right. Yeah, found the key to the drawer. Everything's normal here. A cassette player here, old school. So let's check out the samurai statue here. This guy. Oh, it's unavailable. That's Uncle Philip. Let's turn on the lights. There you are, Uncle Philip. Uncle Philip!
Alyssa, you're okay!
Who the hell are you? What kind of place is this? It's like a haunted house.
Alyssa, no! No! Impossible!
Alyssa's asleep. I'm here instead.
I forgot. I'm currently being possessed. So I guess I should have put down my amulet first before talking to Uncle Field. Because as we know, Clock Tower has multiple endings. Oh, Uncle Philip is no longer here. We have a drawer key, right? Let's try using our drawer key here. Nothing happens. Alright, so let's go downstairs. We got a lot of rooms here in the first floor. Alright, so this door is now available. So let's check. All right. Okay, this is a drawer. Yes.
Hey, look at this.
A cult python. Still not available. Ooh, what's this?
It's Alyssa's amulet.
All right, so as you can see, we are no longer shining, so technically we just came back from being Alyssa. Everything's normal here. What? Creepy.
Ha ha ha!
There must be something interesting in here. That's why the doll appears. Let's check.
Wow, it's so full.
Nice one. I have a gun, right? Can use it. So this is the challenge here. Since we have two personalities, we need to check these doors both as Aliza and as Bates. So earlier this door is not yet available, but now let's check. And where's the switch? I think the switch is outside. There. Yeah, I found a pistol, but left what? I didn't catch it. But left it where it is. So there are two pistols in this game.
There's something written here. It says, help.
That might be Aunt Catherine. Alright.
Yeah, how creepy.
Alright, so it's moving.
Must be broken.
I'm going to kill you.
All right.
Ha ha!
Oh, this door is locked, right? We're screwed. You died. All right, let's continue. We can now use the gun, but it's not working. Yes, we can use this. Oh, wrong way, wrong way. Yes, let's continue. Wrong way again. Alright, so let's try this. Let's try this. Actually kill Scissorman with this. Well, my intention actually was to let her fall here in the balcony or terrace, like what I did with Scissorman, but it's not working. I guess our only choice is to hide again. Here. There's a cabinet right here, right? Let's try this. Yeah. See? Just like what we did in Scissorman, Clock Tower Scissorman. Alright.
I wonder whose attaché case this is.
So, let me just put down this amulet so that we can change our personality. We just need to find the place where we can put this amulet down, because as per hint, right, it was stated that we do have two personalities. There you go. Alright. So we can now change our personality as Bates. So for us, in order to change our personality aside from putting down the amulet, we need to encounter our enemies, basically. How about using our pistol here? See? Oh, yeah, it's not working. Nice one. Alright, so I already picked up that med kit earlier, but as you can see, we have another med kit. So whenever I'm panicking, like whenever this cursor is red, I just need to go here, in here, so that we can get medicines. I'll inhale. Oh, the telephone is ringing. Let's check. Is it? Let me just get our amulet. Yes. Alright, change personality. Back to Aliza.
Oh, the lion's dead.
Epic fail. The samurai guy is no longer here. I saw a statue earlier. Let's get that statue. Here.
Statue? What is this? It's possessed! Ouch! It has some kind of power.
So I guess we need to change personality as Bates. So we can pick up this statue. I'm not really sure if this is the same statue. The same statue in Clock Tower Scissorman. Ooh. Alright, that's good. Let's try.
I can't touch it, but why? I can't touch it, but why?
That's because you don't have the power. So we need to change personality to Bates. I need to encounter the cursed doll. Let's see if this works. It's gonna be awesome. Oh, there you are. Yeah, we change to bait.
That power. Dangerous.
Still.
That power. Dangerous.
Alright, so that's pretty much it. Oops. That's fine. Well, I just wish that he's no longer here. The samurai guy. Still here. Alright, so let's just wait for a couple of minutes then.
Yellow blood.
Yes. The door is locked. All right. So there's a piano upstairs. I think we should be able to play it as Aliza. Let's try. See? Yeah. And nothing happens. No keys, no anything.
I can't touch it. But why?
Aunt Catherine, Uncle Philip.
This isn't a game.
This isn't a game. That's Jennifer.
This isn't a game.
Of Clock Tower Scissorman. There must be a key somewhere here.
Ashley!
Decapitated Ashley.
Stephanie?
Alright, so we were able to open this door. There must be a key somewhere.
I wonder where Michael went.
Alright, so we found a key. Remember the door in the dining area? Let's try. Oh, bedroom key. Bedroom key. In any case, so we can change our personality to Bates and we can use our pistol. I will put down this amulet here. Alright, let's open this door. Still locked. Alright.
I wonder whose attaché case this is.
Let's see if the guy's still here. Unfortunately, all right.
That power. Dangerous. That power. Dangerous.
So I have the bedroom key. Let's try. Boom, bingo. Oh, okay. This is Michael's room. Alright, so let's read some walkthroughs about this bedroom key in Clock Tower to struggle within. Because I think I already checked all locked doors, but still. Bedroom key. Clock Tower. Let's read. Alright, so location, wardrobe, Michael's room, Tate house, appearance. The bedroom key is an item in Clock Tower to struggle within. The bedroom key is a required key to unlock the master bedroom. The bedroom key can be found at second floor. So where is this master bedroom? So we will unlock master bedroom So where is master bedroom? Okay. Phone is ringing. Let's check.
Stop, please.
And yeah, now it's working. Crazy.
Don't come out.
All right. Now saving. I guess it's a bad ending. That's weird because I actually tried opening the door without the amulet so that in any case, if we encountered Stephanie, we can use our gun. But unfortunately, we were killed by Stephanie here. Ending rank is M. Well, I wish I saved the game prior that event so that we can try other scenario, maybe. There are no checkpoints. That's the least. Alright, so I guess that's pretty much it, guys. See you on the next stream. So I might stream another Clock Tower 2, and I might read some walkthroughs as well, so that we can finish this game in, I would say, good fashion. Maybe like ending B or A, like what we did with Clock Tower Scissorman, wherein you finish it with ending B. So yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. See you in the next PlayStation Mouse episode of Clock Tower. Yeah.